Good morning, everyone. Welcome to another video from Kimmel Bay Church, bringing us an encouragement from God's Word. 5 to 10 minutes to encourage us on some of the characters that we find in the Bible. We've had a few lesser known characters recently, and I've had to honestly scratch my head and say, who did they say, and go and have a look. But today's passage is a very well known character to Christians and non-Christians as well, because I'm sure everyone has heard of John the Baptist. And we found John in the New Testament, obviously. But let's be honest, John was a bit weird. He was a bit odd. He was a bit different. He was a bit out there. What does it tell us about him? He lived in the wilderness and he wore a garment made of camel's hair with a belt wrapped around his waist. And he ate locusts and wild honey. I've seen that I'm a Celebrity program just once recently when they were eating some sort of creatures and weird and horrible things. I don't think I could do that on a daily basis. But that was what John did. That's what the Bible tells us. Just a little side note here. Does God want us to be weird like John the Baptist, to walk around in camel's hair, jacket and walking down the street telling people to repent? I'm not sure, personally, I'm not sure that will bring people closer to God or push them away. If you have a different opinion than me, then please forgive me and the best of luck to you. But this is John's specific calling for him in his life. So John was out in the wilderness dressed like that, and people started going out to him because he was preaching to them, and people said to John, John, who are you? Are you the Messiah? No, he said. Are you the prophet? No. Are you the Elijah figure? And he said, no. And then they said, well, John, who are you? And he said this, he says, I'm the voice of one calling out in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord. He didn't give them a straight answer, did he? He would have made a good politician. But actually, he was quoting to them a passage from the book of Isaiah that talked about a specific person who would come to prepare the way before the Messiah figure, before Jesus arrived. And that's what John was saying, I am this person preparing the way for the Lord. And how did exactly John prepare the way for the Lord? Well, he preached to the crowds that were coming out to him, and it says that John appeared in the wilderness and he was preaching a repentance of a forgiveness of sins. So he was essentially telling the crowds, look, stop living the way that you've been living. It's wrong. You're not living to please God. You're living to please yourselves. But there's a better way to live. So come and be baptized and show that, confess your sins and turn and start living the way that God wants you to live. And that's what's essentially what John's message was. And a side note to preachers and leaders here, John was a popular guy. Everyone was going out to him. And there's a danger that when you stand up in front of people, when you become a leader of people or pastor or whatever it is, that there's a danger that pride and ego can creep in to your life and into your heart. And I love the response of John, because as John was baptizing, Jesus started his ministry after John had baptized him. And John's disciples came to John and he says, John, that Jesus guy, he's baptizing people and more people are now going to him. What was John's response? It was a great example of attitude and character of humility. John said this, he must become greater and I must become less. Isn't that a great example of how we should live our lives? And a credit to Gordon here, because that's one of his life verses, that he must become greater and I must become less, and having a humble attitude, but don't tell him. So John had a specific calling and a specific mission or a specific purpose that God had called him to in his life. And we said that John was preparing the way for the Lord. And one way he did that was he was preaching to the crowds. But another way, he was pointing people to Jesus. He was pointing people not to himself, but to Jesus. And one day he did that literally, because Jesus walked past and he said to the crowds, look, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. And essentially, John was always saying, look at him, don't look at me, look at him. And John also says, I'm baptizing you with water, but one day there's one coming who's going to baptize you with the Holy Spirit. And that's what John's purpose was, to point people to Jesus, to prepare their hearts for this Messiah figure that was coming. And that was a great example of John showing, look at Jesus. He's the one that can save you. He's the one that can transform your heart and do an amazing thing in your life. John was fully committed. He was devoted. He was determined to fulfill that specific call that God had placed on his life. Even so much so that it cost him his life, because he stood up for the truth. He stood up for what was right, and he called out Herod for marrying his brother's wife, didn't he? And it cost him his head. He was beheaded. So he was fully committed to stand up for the truth in his generation and to fulfill what God had called him to do. But what about me and you 2,000 years later? Does God have a specific calling on our lives, a specific purpose, something that we should be doing? Yeah, he does. He clearly tells us in the Bible that we should go and make disciples of all nations and telling them about the good news that Jesus saves and transforms lives. What's the best way, or what's the most impact that we can have in our generation? Is it by wearing camel's hair and walking up and down the streets, preaching at people? It might be for you. I don't think it's for me. One of my favourite verses is in Romans. It's chapter 8, verse 29. And it says that we should be conformed to the image of his son. So that we should be like Jesus. We should be transformed to become more like Jesus. We should act like Jesus, think like Jesus, behave like Jesus. We should love like Jesus. We should care for the outcasts like Jesus. We shouldn't get involved in gossip. We shouldn't get involved with the way that this world lives. But we should be like him. Be full of love and grace and truth. And then people might say, look, there's something different about that person. Look at how they act around others. But instead of me encouraging you how to live like Jesus and how to prepare the way for the Lord, I'm going to leave you with a song of several hundred Marines singing, "These Are the Days of Elijah." Have a great day, and God bless everyone. Bye-bye.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. I know these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sword. Still we are the out. There's no God.